Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ekeeda.
Hello friends, in today's video, we are going to see what are the different problems based on crystal oscillator. That means to find out the resonant frequency, which may be series or parallel, or to find out the quality factor of the crystal oscillator. So let's start with the topic. The statement of first problem is, a crystal has L equals to 0.33 Henry, C1 equals to 0.065 picofarad, C2 equals to 1 picofarad, and R equals to 5.5 kilo ohms. Find series resonant frequency and Q factor of the crystal. We know that the crystal oscillator equivalent circuit consists of a series connection of RLC1 and it is connected parallelly with the capacitor C2. So, based on this, we have two frequencies, that is series resonant frequency and parallel resonant frequency. So, first we'll write down a given data and find out the series resonant frequency by using the given data. C1 equals to 0.065 picofarad, C2 equals to 1 picofarad, L equals to 0.33 Henry, and R equals to 5.5 kilo ohms. So the formula of Fs is 1 upon 2 pi square root of L C1, so which is equals to 1 upon 2 pi square root of L is 0.33 into C1 is 0.065 picofarad. So the value of series resonant frequency is given as Fs is equals to 1.09 into 10 raised to 6 hertz. The series resonant frequency is nothing but the frequency at which the resonant of inductor is similar to the resonant of capacitor C1. That's why in the formula we consider value C1. Now second thing we need to find out is nothing but the Q factor, that is nothing but quality factor. And it is given by the formula 2 pi FSL divided by R. We have already calculated the value of Fs. We already have a value of inductor resistor. So let's substitute the value and find out quality factor. Therefore, Q equals to 2 pi into 1.09 10 raised to 6 into 0.33 Henry divided by value of resistor is 5.5 kilo ohms. So we will get Q factor as 411. So this is how we can find out the resonant frequency and quality factor of the crystal oscillator. Now let's move to the next problem. The statement of the problem is, a crystal has L equals to 0.5 Henry, C1 0.06 picofarad, Cp is 1 picofarad and R equals to 5 kilo ohms. Find out series and parallel resonant frequency and Q factor. Here instead of C2, they have mentioned value of C2 as Cp, which is used for calculation of parallel resonant frequency. So first we will write whatever given in the problem. So given data is L is 0.5 Henry, C1 is 0.06 picofarad, C2 is 1 picofarad, R equals to 5 kilo ohm. C2 is nothing but Cp as mentioned in the problem. So first find out series resonant frequency Fs by using formula 1 upon 2 pi square root of LC1, which is equals to 1 upon 2 pi square root of inductor value is 0.5 and C1 value is 0.06 picofarad. So we will get Fs equals to 920.43 kilohertz. Now, next thing is to find out parallel resonant frequency Fp. The formula for Fp is Fp is equals to 1 upon 2 pi square root of L C equivalent. And C equivalent is given by formula C1 C2 upon C1 plus C2. So, this is equals to 0.06 pico into C2 is nothing but Cp, which is equals to 1 picofarad divided by 0.06 pico plus 1 picofarad. So we will get C equivalent as 0.057 into 10 raised to minus 12 farad. So by substituting this value of C equivalent in the formula, we can get the value of Fp. So Fp is now equals to 1 upon 2 pi square root of value of inductor is same, that is 0.5 Henry into 0.057 into 10 raised to minus 12. Therefore, we'll get Fp is equals to 942.8 kilowatts. Now, the next thing in the problem is to find out the value of quality factor, which depend upon the value of series resonant frequency, that is Fs. So, quality factor, that is nothing but Q factor. So, Q factor is equals to 2 pi Fsl divided by R. So, we already have a value of inductor, we have a value of resistor. Fs is just now we have calculated. So, we'll get 2 pi into 920.43 into 10 raised to 3, which have we calculated, into value of inductor is 0.5 Henry divided by resistor, given value is 5 into 10 raised to 3, that is 5 kilo ohms. So we will get Q factor is equals to 577. So this is how we can calculate the series resonance frequency, parallel resonance frequency along with the Q factor. So I hope you understand these problems. So thank you very much for watching this video. Stay tuned to Ekeeda. Subscribe Ekeeda. Thank you.